Hi, my name is Jesse Felix, a product manager here at Amazon S3. In this segment, we're going to dive deeper into the S3 Intelligent Tiering Storage class. What is it? How does it work? And when should you use it? S3 Intelligent Tiering is the only storage class in the world that optimizes storage cost automatically as data access patterns change. And since its launch in 2018, we've delivered over $250 million in storage cost savings back to our customers, and that number keeps growing every single day. To deliver storage cost savings, S3 Intelligent Tiering automatically moves objects between three access tiers for a small monthly monitoring and automation charge, with no impact on performance and no operational overhead. When data moves between access tiers as your access patterns change, there's no lifecycle transition charges, and there are no retrieval charges. All of this while providing the highest durability and the highest availability. S3 Intelligent Tiering is designed for 11 nines of durability and 3 nines of availability. Next, let's talk more about how Intelligent Tiering works and when exactly should you use it. When you upload or transition data into the Intelligent Tiering storage class, objects are first stored in the frequent access tier, at which point S3 Intelligent Tiering will begin to monitor access of every single object stored in exchange for a small object and automation charge. Any objects not accessed for 30 consecutive days are automatically moved to the infrequent access tier at 40% lower storage cost. And with the recently launched Archive Instant Access tier in 2021, Intelligent Tiering now automatically delivers storage cost savings of 68% compared to the infrequent access tier for objects that are not accessed for a total of 90 consecutive days. To recap, there are no lifecycle charges as data moves between access tiers, no retrieval charges, and no impact on performance. You should use S3 Intelligent Tiering if you have data with unknown or changing or unpredictable access patterns. These use cases include data lakes, data analytics, and content sharing applications where customers cannot identify when a data set that is infrequently accessed at a specific point in time will become frequently accessed again in the future. For example, many customers use S3 Intelligent Tiering as their default storage class for data lakes, which are accessed by many users and applications for business analytics, machine learning, and data engineering pipelines. And for these use cases, you cannot easily predict when access patterns for your data will change in the future. Let's now talk how customers are using S3 Intelligent Tiering to automate their data archiving strategy for data that is not accessed for a year or even longer. S3 Intelligent Tiering offers two optional asynchronous archive access tiers: an archive access tier with standard retrievals within 3 to 5 hours, and a deep archive access tier with standard retrievals within 12 hours. The S3 Intelligent Tiering archive and deep archive access tiers are ideal if your application can access objects asynchronously and achieve storage cost savings of up to 95% for data that has not been accessed for months at a time. You can choose one or both of the asynchronous access tiers depending on your application requirements. The minimum number of days of no access before S3 Intelligent Tiering automatically moves data to the archive access tier is 90 days, and 180 days for the deep archive access tier. If you have business requirements where the data needs to be immediately accessible for even longer, you can extend the time to move data to the asynchronous archive access tiers by up to 2 years. To illustrate, here we show an example when you turn on the deep archive access tier to automatically archive data that hasn't been accessed for a year. Once you turn on the asynchronous access tiers within S3 Intelligent Tiering, you can also get automatic notifications to track when objects are moved to the archive access or the deep archive access tier. We also want to emphasize additional optimizations S3 Intelligent Tiering delivers that you should know about. First, any objects that are smaller than 128 kilobytes are not eligible for auto tiering. They are not monitored and they are not charged. Second, S3 Intelligent Tiering no longer has a minimum storage duration period. which means that any objects deleted within 30 days do not incur any early delete charges. With the increasing number of customers that are using S3 Intelligent Tiering as their default storage class, customers often want to know what the most cost-effective way to store their data is. And the answer to that is that you can specify Intelligent Tiering in the Put API Request header. And when you do that, it ensures that any objects that are uploaded will automatically be stored in the S3 Intelligent Tiering storage class. This concludes our presentation for today. I want to thank you for your time. To get started with the S3 Intelligent Tiering storage class, you can do so within the Amazon S3 console. Thank you.